Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. In this episode, let me show you how to use Keynote to create interesting photo journals that you could share with friends and family online. So the old iPhoto app used to have a really cool journaling feature on the iPad that allowed you to create these really cool photo journals and share them online. Now that that's gone, you could still use lots of different apps to create interesting online photo journals, but you can actually do it on your Mac with the software you've got there. You can use Keynote in conjunction with Photos or even just with images on your hard drive to create and share some really interesting photo journals with people, and they don't need to have Keynote on their end. So in Keynote here, we create a presentation. There are actually some here that are already meant for photos, like photo essay, photo portfolio, things like that. But we could just start with a blank presentation with just a black background, and we can create a simple photo album. And you could put whatever you want in it that you would put in a normal Keynote. So we could start off with a frame like that doesn't even have any photos, and you could add slide and then pick one of the default slides here. So let's pick this one because it's got a bunch of photos in it. And notice that you can click on these little photo things here and then select a photo from your photos collection to add. So I can select that one there. I'll go here and I'll select another photo. And you know, it leaves you in the mode where you can edit the photo itself. So you can crop it, do all sorts of different things. But let's just stick to just the basic drag and drop stuff right now where you're going to add stuff in. Yeah, and you can actually drag and drop photos in as well. So let's create another slide here that's just this big one here with this big photo. And I'll drag a photo from the desktop in so you can see it's easy to do. And then you can also create slides that are just blank and add photos. So you can either drag or drop photos from photos. So here's my photos app running, and I can go in here and just drag and drop right from photos into Keynote, and you'll see it'll insert that photo in there. So it's kind of exporting it and importing it into Keynote, and I could just move that around any way I want. It's really easy to do. I can drag photos from the desktop as well, which is what I just did. I just dragged from the Finder in there. And you could put all sorts of photos in here and do all sorts of cool things with them. Anything that you can do in Keynote. Now, we're not going to do any kind of special transitions or animations or build-in, build-outs, because they're not going to translate, because somebody's going to be viewing this in a browser. It's not going to have all that functionality. But I can do something like, for style, I can choose a special frame, and that will work. I could go in to here, for instance, and I can go to Arrange, and I can even rotate something if I wanted to, and we'll see that that actually is going to show up. And once I've got my presentation like what I want, I can even add text and shapes here. So I can add some text, and I could add a shape. I can add an arrow, for instance. So after I've got everything like I want it, I could go ahead and then share this presentation so others can view it. Now, it's important to save this as a document in your iCloud account. So go out to Save and choose iCloud Keynote and save it in iCloud. Then once you've done that, of course, it's saved to your local hard drive and it will sync to iCloud and be available on your other devices as well. But once you've got it saved to iCloud, now I can click the Share button and I can share a link to this on iCloud. Now, when I share a link to it, I get to set it to view only or allow editing. For most cases for photo journals, you want to set it to view only. You just want people to view your photos. You can then invite people, but you don't need to do that. I'm going to switch to copy link, which basically turns off the invitation thing, and then we'll be able to just copy and paste a link into anything we want. Another option here is to use a password. So this is going to be at a public URL that nobody will know is there unless you tell them is there. But if you really want some security, you could add a password and then tell your friends and family what the password is, just to add a little extra security. Although the chances of somebody stumbling upon your photo journal are slim, and if somebody shares your photo journal with somebody else, they could naturally share the password as well. So you can use that if you want to. Let's hit Share Presentation and it'll go through a process preparing to share. And when it's all done, you can click the share button again. You can view share settings, and under that you'll see the link. And you could click on it to copy the link. And you could also, if you want to re-invite people, you can do that clicking here and then sending them an email. So this link is all they need now to actually go and view this photo journal. Now I'm using the browser Chrome instead of Safari, and I'm doing that to demonstrate that you don't need to be using Safari on a Mac in the latest version of OS X to view this photo album. It actually works in any modern browser. I've even tested this on Windows, and even though you get a message saying that not all features are supported, it does show everything that I've done in the photo album. So I'll go to this URL here. I just pasted it in. I'm not signed into iCloud. I'm not using iCloud at all with this browser here. So you can pretend that this is somebody that does not have an iCloud account, or maybe they're viewing it on a Mac that's not even theirs. And after the little welcome message there, you can see there's the presentation. It's set to view only. They can jump around to all the slides they want. You can see here even the text and the arrow and the framing was all put in place, even the rotation here. And not only can they just view it, but they have some other options as well. They could hit the playback button and it goes full screen. And they can use the arrow keys to move forward. Hit the escape key to go back. That's just part of the browser functionality. It's nothing special to do with Keynote in particular. They even have the ability to print and download. So this is great for people that, if you want to share photos of your trip with your family members or friends and you want to put together a nice photo journal, you can do that in a similar way you were able to do it in the past with the iPhoto, or can do it with other apps. You can just do it here in Keynote, and it works great. It gives you lots of chances to be very creative in how you present your photos and share them with your friends.